All right, hi again, it's Mr. Smith, and we're going to be doing homework two. I'm going to be doing it on the computer, so this will be a little different, but let's try this. Postulate 1.4 states that any three non-collinear points lie in exactly one plane. That means if we're looking at this plane, these three points can only be in one plane. Find a plane that contains the first three points listed, then determine whether the fourth point is in that plane. Write coplanar or non-coplanar to describe the points. So number 27 says Z, S, and Y. So let's look for Z, S, and Y. Like we've said before, any three points have to be coplanar. And you can tell the Z, S, and Y lie inside this plane here. The fourth point we need to talk about is C. Does C also lie in the same plane? It does. So these four points are coplanar. So you write the word coplanar, which is written right here, coplanar. Next, S, U, V, and Y. Here's S, here's U, here's V. So they lie in this plane right here. And Y, the fourth point, also lies in the plane. So S, U, V, and Y are also coplanar. 29. We'll look at X, Y, Z, and then U. Here's X, here's Y, here's Z. X, Y, and Z are all part of this plane right here. So the question is U on that plane? U is over here, it is not part of this plane. So X, Y, Z, and U are non-coplanar. The word is right there, non-coplanar. 30, X, S, V, and U. So first we need X, here's S, here's V. So X, S, and V are on this plane here. U is over here, so that's the same plane. So we would write coplanar for number 30. 31, X, Z, S, and V. So we're going to look at X, Z, and S. X is here, Z is up here, S is here. So X, Z, and S are all on this plane. And our last choice, our last one we got to check is V. So X, Z, and S are on this plane, but V is over here. It's not on the same plane. So these four points are non-coplanar. Last, 32. S, V, C, and Y. Here's S. Here's V, here's C. S, V, C, and Y. Okay, well, S, V, and C are on a plane, but it's hard to see what that plane is because it's not shown here. So, S, V, C, and Y are on sort of a plane that would be kind of perpendicular to these other two planes. But I gotta say, it doesn't look like Y would be on it because Y is behind S like that. So Y looks like it's too far back. That's a tough one. This book does like to give us some trick problems. So we're gonna say non-coplanar, but that one's a little harder to figure out. Okay, if possible, draw a figure to fit each description. Otherwise, write not possible. Four points that are collinear, that's very easy. All you do is draw four points, 1, 2, 3, 4, in a straight line, and they would be collinear. Number 34, two points that are non-collinear. Well, that's bullcrap, because if you take any two points, you can always draw a straight line through them. So all you got to do is draw two points and prove that you can draw a straight line. It is impossible to draw two points that are non-collinear. 35, three points that are non-collinear. That's pretty simple. All you got to do is draw a point here, another one over here, and another one over here. As long as they're not in a straight line, you've got three non-collinear points. It's pretty easy. 36, three points that are non-coplanar. Well, that's impossible. We can go back up to what it says up here. Postulate 1.4 says that any three non-collinear points lie in exactly one plane. In other words, if they lie in one plane, they are coplanar. So 36 is saying to draw three points that are non-coplanar, it's impossible. Any three points will always be coplanar. All right, 37, draw a figure with points B, C, D, E, and F, and G that shows line CD, line BG, and line EF with one of the points on all three lines. All right. Since none of the points are repeated here, all you've really got to do is draw three lines that cross each other. And then make sure that, say, B is the name of the place where they cross. So draw line CD, then draw line BG passing it, where B crosses CD, and then draw EF crossing both of them with B also as part of line EF. Not very hard also, I don't think really that important. Okay, think about a plan. Your friend drew the diagram at the right to prove to you that two planes can intersect in exactly one point. Describe your friend's error. Okay. So first of all, how do you describe a plane? Well, a plane is a flat surface. But the thing about planes, just like lines, is they never end. So just because this here is a picture of a plane doesn't mean that it touches this other plane in exactly the one point. Because this plane is supposed to extend forever. So is this one. And when they extend, then their intersection won't be in exactly one point, but it'll be all along the line where the two planes cross. Just like up here, where the two planes cross, they cut through each other. Because they never end, their intersection will always be a straight line. Okay, 39, reasoning. If one ray contains another ray, are they the same ray? They are not. We can prove it right here. Look at this. Here's this ray here, starting at S and going in this way. Then look at point X and start in X and going the same way. So the ray that goes from X and goes through Y contains the ray that starts at S and goes through Y. But the first ray that starts at X is larger because it contains this extra segment. So they are not the same ray. Again, just because this ray contains this ray doesn't mean they're the same, because this one, the first one, is longer. It starts earlier. Okay, 40 through 45. Determine whether each statement is always, sometimes, or never true. Line TQ and line QT are the same line. They are because they go endless in both directions. There is no beginning and no end, so you can name it in either order. So that is always true. 41. Ray JK and ray JL are the same line, or sorry, the same ray. Well, they both start at J, so assuming that it can go J through K and L on to forever, then it would definitely be the same ray. If, on the other hand, K is over here, and here's J, and L is over here on the other side, then they are not the same ray. So that one is a clear example of something that is sometimes true. All right, number 42, intersecting lines are coplanar. That's interesting. When you draw any two lines crossing, imagine two rulers, or if you have two pencils, put them on top of each other and cross them. What you'll notice is that you can put a piece of paper flat against them. Any two lines, this is always true. If you do it with two toothpicks on a table, any two intersecting lines will end up flat and forming a plane. In other words, intersecting lines are always coplanar. 43, four points are coplanar. That's pretty easy to prove. It's not true. It's sometimes true, I guess. It's easy to draw four points on a piece of paper, and if you can draw them on a piece of paper, then they are coplanar. But you can also draw three dots in a triangle shape and another dot up above the paper, and that would prove that they weren't all on the same plane. So 4 points are coplanar is a sometimes true statement, not always. 44. A plane containing 2 points of a line contains the entire line. That's interesting. Imagine this plane up here contains a point here and another point here that are on a line. Well, that would mean that that line would go like this across the plane. The plane goes forever, and the line goes forever. And if both of those points are on the plane, then that line will never leave the plane. It'll be right on the whole time. Meaning that a plane containing two points of a line contains the entire line is something that is always true. As soon as two points of that line are on that plane, all of that line is on that plane. 45. Two distinct lines intersect at more than one point. Alright, try to imagine crossing two toothpicks. If they're two different, and the word distinct means different, if you have two different toothpicks touching each other, they're only going to touch in one spot. They can't touch in more than one spot, because if they did, they would be the same line. And if they're the same line, then they are not distinct. So that answer is false. It is never true. 46. Use the diagram at the right. How many planes contain each line and point? How many planes contain line EF? Well, here's line EF. It is part of plane HEFG. It is also part of plane PEFQ. But how many contain line EF and point G? Only one. The only one that contains line EF and point G is plane HEFG. All right, B, containing line PH and point E. So here's PH here, and point E is over here. The only plane that contains line PH and point E would be plane PHE right here. C, line FG and point P. Here's line FG. Here's point P over here. All right, this is one of those ones that's hard to see, but imagine a plane that goes diagonally across this prism. It contains this line and this point. It would be a plane that goes diagonally across, and you would have to call it plane FGP. None of these other points would be part of it. D, line EP and point G. Here's line EP, here's point G. This is basically the reverse of the last one. You could still imagine a diagonal plane that comes across from P through G, and it can includes E. It would not include H or F or Q, and the name of it would be plane PGE. And last, reasoning. What do you think is true of a line and a point not on the same line? All right. If you have a line and you have a point that's not on that line, then that point is not collinear with the line, but it will end up being on the same plane. If you think about it, you can draw a line, put a point somewhere else, and no matter where you put that point, you'll be able to connect a plane that touches the entire line and the point. So the answer is, it will be non-collinear with the line, but coplanar with the line. Okay. I hope that was helpful. Best of luck. Hey, email me your questions. I'll help out.